everyone. Welcome to another episode of GTV. This is, again, Business Over Coffee. And today, my guest is one of my business partners, actually. So, Nina here. This is my friend, Nina Mendoza. Hi, Nina. How are you?
Hi, Jane. Hi, everyone. I miss you. Buti na lang nakita tayo bago mag-lockdown. Anyway.
Oo nga. Just before lockdown, no? Just before lockdown. So, okay. Nina here is a Facebook ad strategist. I mentioned that she's my partner, no? Because we have some engagements with Facebook for some of their sprints that they do with companies. So, we send out animators for that. Also, she's the founder and mentor at Success Squad and head of digital marketing at Open Minded Kaba Media. So, yon. So, Nina, baka you can tell us more about yourself before we delve into the topic.
Yeah, and sige. Yun nga, Jinch. You're one of my business partner, and then meron akong mga nakilala along the way na kailangan din nila ng help with digital marketing or Facebook advertising mainly. So, yung sa OMKB, it's for the entertainment industry. Mm-hmm. So, more on digital marketing on that aspect. And then, we also have partners like mga PR companies. And mostly, yun yung mga ginagawa namin. Pero, yung talagang parang main business ko is a digital marketing agency. So, we cater to local and international clients running Facebook ads for them. Before, I used to do mga podcasting services, website development, and all that stuff. But, you know, 4 years ago, I decided to cut my clients and let go of them. Because I just want to focus on one thing. Pero from the start naman, I was doing Facebook advertising. Since nung nag-transition ako from being an employee to becoming a freelancer. Tapos yun ngayon.
So this company is New Media Market. New Smart Marketing. Yes, New Smart Marketing.
Okay. Pinilit ko yung initials ko. Kasi NSM Nina Santiago.
Okay. Ngayon ko lang nalaman yun. Alam ko lang like, New Smart Marketing. Okay.
25, I wanna do it again. Siyempre, ayoko, parang New Smart ang corny, diba? So anyway, pinilit lang. Magre-refund ako.
So how long have you been doing Facebook ads for clients and for yourself?
2014.
So that is six years na. Tagal na. Wow. Okay. So, you know what? To everyone who's watching, sa mga viewers, Nina's helped us tremendously sa Facebook ads namin. And that's the reason why I invited her here. I know that you've already seen the video of Anne, no? By the time that we come out with this live session. Today we're gonna tackle a different thing naman in terms of like Facebook ads. We're gonna discuss the different KPIs or the different metrics na that is seen in your Facebook ads reports. So that's our topic for today. And Nina will take us through it. Okay, so I know that you will share slides, right?
Yes.
You can share it now with us. Okay. And maybe we can talk about it na lang along the way.
Can you see my slide?
Yes, we can. There you go. We can see it.
Yeah, okay. So understanding Facebook ads metrics, like what you said, Anne talked about how to run ads, the basic stuff. Now, I'm just going also to share basic stuff lang ng metrics na yung Facebook. Kasi I don't want to overwhelm our viewers. Pero there are still a lot of advanced metrics that we can talk about in the future. But this one, I want to make it something actionable din. Na di sila ma-overwhelm with numbers because of course not a lot of people like numbers like understanding numbers, diba? So yeah. Ayan. Next is I will borrow this parang DMAIC structure. This is from the Six Sigma na one of the system or tools na ginagamit, DMAIC. So define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. This is the DMAIC cycle. We're just gonna use this to have a flow of how we can understand the metrics. Kasi it's not just about understanding the metrics. One of the reasons why, or big reason why we want to understand the metrics is because we want to improve, right? And why do we want to improve? We have a goal in mind. So, para lang meron tayong flow, bahira muna ng DMAIC cycle ni Six Sigma. So, First is define. What do we need to define? No? There are a lot of things that we can define right at the beginning. So we can define where we are at. So lagi na naririnig to ng mga tao yung point A and point B. Parang you have to also define your goal. It's always been said, diba, na always define your goal. Your goal is actually your point B. But in understanding also the metrics and knowing how you can get there, you also have to define your point A. Where are you at right now, diba? So parang in a relationship, you want to be with that person. Pero nasan ba kayo ngayon? Friend zone ba kayo? Scene zone ka ba? Or stranger ka ba? So just to put context into that.
Yes.
Define where you are right now. Define where you want to go. Define where your business is at right now. If you can have some numbers. Most of the time, actually, Jinchen, I have, when I'm consulting with clients din, no, hindi nila alam yung numbers nila. When I say numbers, let's say, I ask them, how many sales do you get in a day? Or how many sales do you get in a month? So parang, meron lang silang gusto na, gusto ko, dumami yung sales ko. Ilan ba yung sales mo last month? Ilan ba yung sales mo kahapon? What are the days na mahina ka? Yung mga simple stuff like that, wala, I know it's simple, kunyari sa atin, pero sa business owner, syempre, they're juggling a lot of things, di ba? All at once. Alam natin yan, Jean. Minsan, yes. 1 month. Madalas. Pero, it's also important to document, especially yung sales. And then yung anything, any number na pwedeng mong ma-document or yung process na pwedeng mong ma-document. That's another topic, documenting process, documenting yes. numbers. Pero you have to define again where you are right now so that you would know what you can bring to point B and what things you need to do to get to point B. Identify all the resources that you have. So, ayun nga, define your goal, define where you are at the business. And then, now, because we're talking about defining, so let's talk about defining the terms, some of the terms. This, again, disclaimer, this is these are just some of the terms na nandoon sa loob ng Facebook metrics inside the ads manager. Pero these are the common ones that we use. And if you are starting, pwede ka makarelate din dito in a basic beginner level. Very easy to understand. Again, I don't want you to be overwhelmed with the words or kung paano siya intindihin. Kasi later on, I will share with you something, mga hacks or tricks. So this is on your left, you will see an example of an ad. So in my screenshot ko to ng isang araw, Netflix. Hello, baka naman. Sponsored ad. Anyway, this is not sponsored in any way. This is sponsored by Ginger. Okay, so Netflix. So when you scroll dun sa Facebook news feed mo, pag desktop, ito yung makikita mo eh. Pero pag phone, syempre yung pinaka hanggang dun lang sa post, diba?
Yes.
So yun yung sponsored ad. This is the Facebook ad. So you will know na Facebook ad siya kasi sponsored. Now, the reason why I show this is because I'm going to talk about the impression first. Impression kasi on Facebook term ha, kasi marami naman definition yan eh. Anong impression ni Google AdWords, anong impression ko sa'yo. Ito impression ko ni Facebook, di ba? Okay, impressions on Facebook definition is the number of times the ad has been served.
Okay.
So, kung nakita ko to, ilang beses mong sinerve yung ad from the Facebook end. So, one na to. Yun yung impression. Pag nakita ko siya ulit dito sa gilid, may nakita ka? Impression na rin itong sponsored yung 611 Entrepreneurs. One impression na rin na counted. Yeah. That's the right placement sa desktop. Tapos, yeah, so yun yung impression. Yun lang isipin nyo. Ilang beses na serve yung ad. So kung billboard lang yan, ang impression yan one lang technically kasi isang beses lang na serve yung ad sa billboard. Di ba? Pero, ibang beses mo siyang nakita. Yun yung frequency dito sa Ford. Pero mamaya na yun.
Okay.
So, CPM. Next, CPM. Jinch, pag may tanong ka, sabihin mo sa akin, ha? Kasi,
oh, sure. Yes. I think naman it's very understandable ngayon. I think naintindihan ng mga viewers natin. And also, okay. Sa mga nanonood, if you have questions, no, feel free to chat it right now sa comments so that we can also answer you na as we go. Okay.
Right. That's right. Yan. Tapos, so, impression. CPM. Cost per mil to. Mm-hmm. Ang ibig sabihin lang nito, how much you are paying for 1,000 impressions.
Yes.
So, let's say, this ad, for 1,000 impressions, the, I don't know, yung kung ad, sino advertiser na to, magbigay na lang tayo ng number. 30 pesos, for example.
Mm-hmm.
So, the advertiser is paying 30 pesos to show the ad to 1,000, to serve the ad 1,000 times.
Yes.
So, yun yung cost per mil.
Kaya siya cost per mil, kasi mil is 1,000, di ba? 1,000. So, kaya cost per mil. Yes.
Cost per 1,000 impressions, yun. Bakit siya important, no? Example, naglagay ka ng tarp. Let's say 50 pesos na tarp. Sobrang liit na, di ba? How much did you pay for that to show that to 1,000, to serve that ad 1,000 times, di ba?
Yes.
So, ganun yung parang comparison na parang saan naabot ang 50 pesos mo?
Yes.
Kasi, sa Facebook kasi, ang pinakamababa or minimum amount that you can spend in a day is it is equivalent to $1. So, before, kaya laging sinasabi parang 50 pesos. No, it's actually not 50 pesos exactly. It is 51 pesos today, 52 pesos tomorrow, depending on the exchange rate. So, baka kasi, maano sabi nila, bakit sabi you can spend as well as 50 pesos, eh 51 yung hinihingi ni Facebook. May error na ganun kay Facebook. Eh. So, it has something to do with the currency conversion. Yun, so CPM. So, think of it, like if you spend like a dollar in running an ad, yung CPM mo is the cost that you pay. Serving it 100 times, 1,000 times, hindi 100, 1,000 people, iba yun eh, yun yung reach. Mm-hmm. Yung reach kasi, yun yung people na na-reach nung ad. So may uniqueness dito. You can serve the ad 2 times to me, that is 2 impressions, pero 1 reach lang.
Got
diba?
It, yes.
Got it, yeah. So, isang tao lang kasi ako, or isang account. Siyempre, hindi naman nila alam. Minsan, kunyari, ginagamit yung account ni Ryan. Pero, you get what I mean. Na-reach na profile. Na-reach na tao. Kung paano man i-define ni Facebook yung tao. Pero, I guess that's the account profile.
Yes. Sure.
Yung frequency is how many times I've seen, how many times the ad has been served. Kunyari, itong same ad na to, dalawang beses ko siyang nakita today. Ang frequency ko noon today is 2.
Okay.
Bakit important yung frequency, no? Tsaka yung mga reach, yung mga CPM. Frequency kasi, di ba meron tayong parang tinatawag na ad fatigue or nasa saturate tayo. If we keep on seeing the same thing psychologically, hindi na natin sa the same thing what we do with people. If lagi mo kasama, parang dinidisregard mo, pero hindi dapat. Ganyan. So,
okay, yung quarantine, lagi mong kasama yung asawa mo, maiinting ulo mo after a few times.
Correct. Ayan. Andiyan si Ryan, naririnig tayo. Diyan mo si EJ.
Hi, Ryan.
Saan ni Ryan? Ano? Pag ako kausap mo, init ang ulo mo. Like, okay. Anyway, ako nag-gaya.
Ang tawag doon, ad fatigue.
At least,
person fatigue.
Di magpag-upit ka na, labas ka muna. Anyway, so yun yung frequency, no? Sa ad fatigue, kaya maraming, meron ding mga variations. So, if mapapansin nyo din, Netflix, for example, shows ads, pero iba-iba sila ng atake. Sometimes, photo lang yan. Sometimes, video siya. Sometimes, i-cater. Katulad nito, the one that they're advertising here is the mobile plan for $149. Diba? Yung mobile plan nila. So, the reason why they do that is because may ad fatigue niya. And so, yung sa frequency namin, this is based on experience, Ginge, and running ads for a lot of clients in different industries.
Yeah.
When we get to see na nag 2.5 na ang frequency, kailangan na namin siyang palitan.
Sige, that's a good tip, ah. Sorry, I'm also writing down notes, kaya dumitin lang sa baba.
A golden tip from also our clients. Kasi syempre, we always optimize and we always run these reports, no? And marami din kaming mga study and analysis na upang nag 2.5, usually yung frequency, bumababa yung, bumababa na yung reach or mahal na.
Costs,
tapos,
yeah.
Yung cost tumataas na, cost per lead, cost per acquisition. So, yun. Sometimes, you will also hear na meron sila mga 3 frequency nila. Okay lang yun. Basta 2.5, 3. Basta magpas ka ng 3, ano na yun. Mm-hmm. Talagang palitan mo na. Tapos pag tinanong niya naman kailan siya dapat palitan yung ad, nagto-talk about na rin ako kung paano siya i-optimize, no? Pero
yeah,
sige.
Sure.
Yung frequency, 2.5 nga. Yung sa ad, usually, hindi mo kasi siya malalaman kung kailan siya magto-2.5 or magto-3. Titingnan mo siya. Kasi depende din siya, Ginger, sa number of people na you are, nung nasa audience mo.
Targeting.
Kasi for example, you all are local business owner and you are only parang yung proximity mo, for example, dito lang sa area na to mag-deliver, mas madaling mo masasaturate, di ba?
Yes.
Or mas madaling ma-add fatigue sila sa'yo. So, kailangan marami kang mga different offers, different gimmicks. Hindi naman ibig sabihin ng different offers is parang iba-ibang discounts. Baka naman isang offer lang, pero iba-ibang angulo.
Oo, with presenting, no?
Oo. So, yun din yung isa sa mga tinuturo namin sa clients namin that we work with na parang, itong offer mo na to, ito namang angulo na to ang tingnan, ang i-add natin.
Uh-oh.
Yes, di ba? So, frequency. Uh-oh. Yun yung sa unsaturation. Pag medyo malaki yung market mo, let's say 1 million and up, I mean, yung audience targeting mo sa Facebook, yung frequency mo, meron kang malaking leeway eh. Mga 2 to 3 months bago ka magbago ng ad ng creative.
Uh-oh.
So, yun, pag local business, based on, again, on our experience, because we also run business ads for let's say, that chiropractors or practitioners or dentists, ganyan.
Yeah.
And since local lang sila, hindi naman, unless digital product yung, in offer ng chiropractor.
Mali yung targeting nila, di ba?
Oo.
Masyadong malaki.
Uh-oh. Usually, nag-change kami ng creatives every 6 weeks. So again, merong mga ganun. Basta may para lang may idea sila. Na okay, if I am a small business owner, I want to run ads, I'll prepare na lang mga 6 different creatives, for example, for a specific offer para hindi yung parang naka-planning ka rin eh, 'di ba? Parang yes. 2.5 na tapos mag-iisip ka na naman. Bakit kapag hindi na lang mag-sit down ka? Isipin mo, anong anim na creatives ang pwede dito? Anong video to or slideshow ang pwede dito? Or anong type of image? Para in that way, pag magpapalit ka na, kuha ka na lang dun sa bank of, ang tawag namin dun, repository ng creatives namin. Kuha ka na lang dun sa bank mo, di ba? So, that's just that one of the hacks that we also do for our clients. Okay. So, that's frequency. Now, we can go to the click. Itong click na to, meron kasi si Facebook na click, tas meron siyang link clicks. So, we talk about clicks first. Yung click dito, ang main measure dito, and every time na nag-click ka doon sa ad. Kasi pag nag-click ka sa ad, for example, kinlik mo yung sign up, or kinlik mo yung image, bilang yun. So, lahat ng clicks na gagawin mo doon sa ad. Yung link click naman, there are some ads that direct that is being directed to a website, for example. Or to a link outside Facebook. Yun yung link click. So, in-measure nila yung clicks doon sa link. Before Facebook, when I was starting, don't have that eh, yung link click, Ginge.
Uh-huh.
Siguro nakita nila na parang it's important also for advertiser to measure how much they are paying para sa visitor ng website. Kasi if click lang kasi, very tricky. Di mo alam. Parang may nag-like lang dyan o click na yan. But if you wanna measure yung visitors ng site from the ads, from the Facebook platform, link clicks yun. Kasi you also have Google Analytics eh, diba? So, para makikita mo, oh, this is from Facebook. Pero, inside the Facebook platform, that is being measured with the link clicks.
Yeah. Okay. I think very simple naman yun.
Yep. Yes. And then, last, dito naman sa parang basic natin, CPC. That's the cost per click. So, how much are you paying for people to click on the ad? Or, kung cost per link click siya, how much are you paying for people to click on the link or visit yung sa site? So, ganun lang siya. Yung cost lang naman. So, minsan sasabihin nila, maraming industry standards sa cost per click, no? Minsan sasabihin, parang, I just want to pay 1 pesos per click.
Mm-hmm.
Or, pag kunyari, ang cost per click mo $10. Syempre, taas. Sa LinkedIn, just to give you an idea, I run the campaign parang, we run campaigns also in other platforms like LinkedIn, Pinterest. Uh-oh. Sa Pinterest, mataas ang cost per click.
Ah, okay.
Pati sa LinkedIn.
Oo, mahal.
Nasa mga, sa LinkedIn, nasa $2 to $3. Alam ko ngayon, parang may sinabi si Anne or isa naming pang kakilala, parang $5 yata minsan. Wow. Again, depende yun sa ano, no? Sa targeting mo, sa audience mo, tsaka baka naman mamaya, hindi sila nakiklik kasi hindi naman engaging yung creative mo. So, you have to look at those. Kasi, if you look at the clicks lang, parang, pwede mo siyang i-compare. Last month, ganito yung cost per click namin. Ngayon, tumaas. So, it can give you an idea. Bakit hindi nag-click yung mga tao? Tingnan ko nga yung frequency. Ah, mataas na yung frequency ko. So, hindi na sila nag-click. Kasi siguro, ad fatigue na. Parang it gives you signs.
So, ano talaga, no? It's really like, babantayan mo talaga yung ads mo. And then, later on, you figure out what's happening. Kung bakit mataas or ang cost or bumababa yung cost, it can be the other way around din na, oy, parang gumaganda, parang okay, yeah, I'm getting to a lot more people.
Yes, that's right. Tapos, gumaganda, especially Facebook is helping you optimize the ads for you.
Yeah.
Kasi sa atin, no, si Facebook, kasi algorithm nga siya, alam nila lahat ng data. Sometimes they listen to us. I don't know.
For ano, like I had this guest no for Google Ads si Ping, and he was telling us that may learning stage si Google for their ads. Ganun din ba si Facebook, and how long is that learning duration?
Yes, merong learning. So merong mga learning limited yung pag makikita mo inside Facebook.
Yes.
Normally, it depends kasi minsan si Facebook, yung learning niya matatapos niya kapag kunyari ang objective mo, let's say is leads. Yeah. Kapag naka 50 leads ka na, tapos na yung learning niya.
Okay.
Minsan ganun. Tapos minsan naman, pag wala ka pang 50 leads, pero let's say na-serve na siya 10,000 impressions, okay na rin.
Okay.
Si Facebook din, very tricky now. Kasi if you make a change, diba kunyari nag-run ka ng ad, tapos nag-change ka ng copy. For example, when I say copy, yung parang words. Mm-hmm. Katulad dito kay Netflix, yung enjoy unlimited shows, yun yung copy or yung text. Or nag-change ka ng headline yung sa baba, Space Force, diba?
Yeah.
Kapag nag-change kang gano'n, nari-reset siya.
Oh, it learns so, again.
Uh-oh. It learns again. Kasi parang iba naman yung sinoshow mo. Kaya minsan sinasabi namin sa mga client, if okay naman yung ano, yung takbo, mm-hmm. Huwag naman na natin baguhin, diba?
Mm-hmm.
Tapos kapag nag-start na lang makita natin yung trend na tumataas na yung cost, ayun na, alam na, mag-check na kami saan na yung pwede nating i-troubleshoot. Parang you don't fix a thing na hindi naman broken.
Mm-hmm.
Siguro yun yung lesson doon, no?
Kasi yung ano talaga, at the end of the day, when you run ads, it's about learning, no? If this is effective. If it's not, then you run another ad, diba? Like another version of it, basically.
Mm-mm. Kaya yung iba naman, para mapabilis din yung learning, throwing more of advertising budget. Pwede din yun. Diba? Para mas mabilis ma-learn. Kasi kami sa testing namin, kasi for example, hindi mo matetest na if this audience works or not eh.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? Or yung specific interest mo or behavior, does it work? So later on, I can share with you para i-backtrack natin doon sa paano yung learning tsaka kung paano mag-testing. Kasi,
okay.
Ito, actually, meron akong example katatapos lang. Hindi ko pwedeng sabihin kung kaninong...
sige. Okay.
Pero, may Father's Day campaign kami. Tapos, so syempre, Father's Day campaign, nag-start siya noong Father's Day.
Yes.
Noong 2015 ba yun?
Yeah.
Basta yun, noong Father's Day. So, initially, when I run, kasi nag-run ako ng mga audience, kung gaano kalaki, anong mga interest yung pwedeng i-target, Ginge, tapos kung saan tayo mas mura. Meron kasing mga audience or interest na mas mura siyang i-target.
Okay.
Versus doon sa mga interest na iba. So, may ganun. So,
may ganun. Okay.
May ganun. Example. Paano ko babibigyan ng example? Example na lang.
Mm-hmm.
Agamula, let's say. Mas mahal, si Aga Mula, for example, ang reach niya is, ang potential reach niya sa Philippines, for example lang ha, 200,000. Tapos kunyari, Alice Dixon, 400,000. Reach niya sa Philippines. Ngayon, kapag nag-run ka ng 50 pesos or 100 pesos a day, makikita mo, mas mura, for example, si Aga, or si, it has wala siyang kinalaman kung gaano kalaki or kaliit. Which is, hindi ko maintindihan din kay Facebook because sometimes, parang pag inisip mo logically, dapat kapag nirun mo, pag pinili mo yung isang mas malaki yung reach, mas mura siya, di ba?
Mura, yeah, kasi big.
Yeah. Pero minsan, actually, pag inisip mo din, mas lalo mong inisip. Baka kasi matap-tough yung competition. Kasi madaming nagta-target nung tao na yun.
Maybe.
Maybe. Magamit nun. So, ikaw, hanap ka. Paano ko matatarget yung same following ni Alice Dixon na 400,000 without targeting her?
Ang galing, ha? Ang galing! Oh. Galing!
Ganun yung ginagawa namin.
It boils down talaga to observation and strategy.
Oo, sa research. So, parang pag sinabi, ito target natin to. Ako talaga pumapasok ako sa Facebook kasi parang in a nutshell, tsaka sa basic, pwede mong sabihin yun eh. Pero kasi ako, I always, parang, saan tayo mas makakatipid na ma-achieve naman natin yung goal natin? Or hindi naman katipid lang. Paano naman yung quality? So, I always take those things into consideration, no? So, ito nga yung kwento, yung sa Facebook ads ng Father's Day. Initially, yung sinabi ko sa client, ang budget natin, 10,000 pesos that day, nung Father's Day, kasi we want to maximize and leverage on that day. Kasi kinabukasan, hindi na Father's Day. So, what's the plan of sense, diba? Tapos sabi ko, so, initially, 10,000 per day. Hmm. And then, the next day, 5,000 na lang per day. Yun yung sabi ko.
Okay.
So, nung Sunday, dinag-run yung ads. Tapos, nag-run din yung ads ng Monday. Since medyo na late yung approved ni Facebook nung Sunday, 3 p.m. onwards namin na run yung ad. So, hindi niya na-consume yung 10,000 pesos na dapat na makonsume niya.
Got it.
Ang ginawa ko, sabi ko dun sa client, pwede ba yung 3,000 na hindi ko nagastos kahapon, gastosin ko na lang ngayong Monday? O, di pumayag. Okay, kasi sabi ko, in-approve mo na yung 10K kahapon. Hindi ka gamitin ko yung 3,000, di ba? Approved daw. O, di eto na. Pagdating ng Tuesday, dapat babalik na kami sa 5K, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
Eh, nakita ko, ang ganda ng response, ang ganda ng results. Sinabi ko sa client, the goal kasi is to reach 1 million views.
Okay.
Sabi ko sa client, pwede ba i-10K na lang natin per day?
Oo.
Tapos, kung na-reach natin yung 1M, i-stop na natin yung campaign.
Oo.
So, yun yung nangyari. Ang target ko talaga, ang target na sinet sa akin, grabe na, mga pressure, 1M views ng Sunday after mga 1 week. Pero na-reach na namin siya nung Friday.
Oh, wow!
So, ibig sabihin, yun yung sinasabi ko sa'yo tukol sa budget, di ba?
Oo.
Kung magka 5,000 tayo per day, how long will it take us to reach 1M? Eh, kung kairin mo naman ng 10K na ngayon, ma-reach na yung 1M para ma-put yung brand mo out there. Tapos meron pa siyang relevance kasi Father's Day video siya.
Oh.
Eh, why not spend? Kasi ang katwiran ko, gagastusin mo din, di ba? Eh, bakit pa natin papatagalin?
Yeah.
Pero again, that is dependent sa mga situation. I don't, parang, hindi ko nilalabi na, oh, may ganyan mas maraming budget or what. Of course, we have people na budget constraints din. And I also work with small business owners na talagang budget constraint. And kapag yun yung maganda din minsan pag mga small yung budgets mo or yung resources mo. Siyempre, mas mapapaisip ka, di ba?
Like, which is like, right.
Yeah. So, mga ganun. I'm just giving you different ideas, different experiences that I have. But you can also learn from them.
Pero not bad, ha? Oo, kung around 10,000 yun, 5 days, kung ilang araw, o sabihin natin 10 days, that's just 1 million views. That's 5 cents, 5 centavos to 10 centavos, no, around that per view, diba? Not bad. I mean, for a big client na may ganong pera, why not, diba?
Yeah. Yung view na yon, ang kinakount ni Facebook is 3 seconds. Pero chinek ko din kasi yung true plays. Ang ibig sabihin ng true plays, parang 10 seconds or 15 seconds or up to until completion.
Ganun pala yun.
Oo. Eh, may autoplay naman eh. Yung 1 million views, kayang-kaya niya. Pero kasi yung true plays namin, more than 16 seconds, doon kasi nag-start bumitaw yung mga tao sa video, 16 seconds to 22 seconds. Nakikita namin sa graph eh.
Mm-hmm.
Ano, nakita ko, yung true plays namin mataas din, nasa around 600,000 to 700,000. So, hindi lang to labanan ng 3-second video na na-autoplay ka lang. Labanan din to ng may nag-stay din, kahit pa paano.
Oo, not bad. Kasi meron ka naman talaga fallout eh. Pag, di ba, pagka, like from 1 million, may fallout ka talaga from that. Na huge percentage pa rin, di ba?
True, true. Parang dito, mga viewers natin, mamaya pa, kakain ako. So.
I'm sure. Marami sa inyo dyan.
Ayan, so, ayan, so, move on na tayo.
Yes,
sa mga
let's move on. Correct, correct.
Thank you. Okay. Screenshot to. Siyempre, bawal ipakita yung ano nun.
Yes, of course.
So, impressions, makikita nyo. Tapos, CPM. So, we're paying 33 pesos dito sa ad set na to. Mm-hmm. Or sa ad na to for 1,000. Ito yung link clicks niya. Cost per click niya, 2 pesos. CTR. Ano yung CTR? Link clicks through. Ibig sabihin, out of the people who saw the ad, ilan yung nag-click?
Mm-hmm.
CTR. Sa link clicks. Pero may CTR ka din na all. So again, mataas ang CTR na all namin, no? Kasi siguro nag-engage sila, like nila yung post, or nagko-comment sila, or nagre-react, yung reactions, nag-i-smiley sila, ganyan.
So yung pala yung difference nung links, ay sorry, yung itong CTR mo dito, at saka CTR all. Kasi yung clicks, it's on the ad. Yung link clicks is basically going to the site. Parang ganon.
Yes, that's right. Mm-mm. Nakalimutan ko na kung anong-ano itong ad to. Pero ayan.
Yeah.
Tapos, ay sorry. Kapag hindi natin alam yung pinaka-metric, sa Facebook, what you can do is you hover over dun sa pangalan. Mm-hmm. Kunyari CPM. Pag hinover mo dun, kapag huwag mong ikiklik, hover mo lang. Mm-hmm. May magpapay lalabas na definition o description nung ano na yon, nung metric na yon. So, ang lesson doon is, if you are overwhelmed or hindi mo siya kabisado, it's okay. Because once you are inside Facebook, you can hover over them and you will read the description or the definition. Tapos, kung if you want to learn more, meron silang mga examples, idadirect ka nila sa help nila or sa support document nila.
Okay.
So, kung overwhelmed ka ngayon, nanonood ka sa akin. Stay ka lang. Ayan yung hack for you. Yan. Di ba? Overwhelmed ka. Eto kasi siya, oh. Sample yung impression hinover ko doon. Impressions. The number of times your ads were on screen. Diba? See more. So, yan. Yan yung secret. Charot.
Yes. Secret. At least na-explain na natin in a, parang, in a very simple way, no, what all of these are. So all they need to know is, kung makalimutan nyo lang kung ano yung video, kung ano yung sinabi namin sa video na to, pwede kang mag-hover over it. And then you'll remember. Ah, oo nga pala, ito yung sinabi ni Nina na, okay, papakita niya sa'yo ng ilang beses yung ad. Yan yung impressions. Diba?
So, yes, that's right. Okay. Let's talk about more things. Etong lifetime customer value, wala siya talaga inside Facebook na metric. Pero I wanna share this para paano natin i-bring yung mga metrics doon sa Facebook. At saka yung identifying our point A and point B.
Yes.
Para, kasi at the end of the day, bakit ka ba nag-ads? Or bakit ka ba nag-digital marketing? Because you wanna grow your business, diba? Mm-hmm. So, I wanna share this simple parang computation or presentation. So, ano yung lifetime customer value? Is a prediction of the net profit attributed to the, sorry, hindi ko mabasa kasi
nakakaroon ng pamatay. Sorry, attributed to the entire future.
To the entire future relationship with the customer, no? So, for example, a dorm tenant stay for a year.
Mm-hmm.
Eh, yung year nila, syempre tenant, is 10 months lang. Kasi tenant siya, dorm tenant, kung ano lang yung school year nila.
Mm-hmm.
Diba?
Yeah.
Di siya apartment na 12 months in a year. So, 10 months yon. And pay 6,000 per month.
Mm-hmm.
Average of stay of tenant, kung hindi ka masungit na landlady, at hindi ka... at maayos naman yung mga kasama mo sa dorm. Pero ito totoo tong ano na to, Jinch, ha? Itong data na to totoo to. It is the data of one of my clients.
Okay.
Average of stay of tenant is 3 years. So hindi to gawa-gawa lang. LTV of a tenant of one tenant is 180,000 pesos.
Okay.
Kasi parang 6,000 kasi times 10 months times 3 years, 180K.
Correct.
Ibig sabihin, ang isang customer mo, ang lifetime value niya dito sa dorm tenant na to is 180K.
Yes.
Why is this important? This is important because later on, if you want to advertise and you have let's say, you're acquiring a customer for 1,000 pesos, for example. Or let's say, 5,000 pesos. Tapos sabihin mo, hi, lugi ako, mahal-mahal naman, 5,000 para dyan sa tenant na yan. No, you have to look at it the lifetime customer value way. Because if you haven't acquired this person from the ads, for example, for let's say 1,000 or 2 or 5,000 or whatever value it may be, wala kang 180K, diba? Pero again, the 180K and the lifetime customer value depends on a lot of factors, diba? Kasi nandyan yung quality of service that you provide in the dorm, may nakaawa yan sa dorm, kahit mabait kayo or what, aalis na yan after 1 year, di ba? Wala nang pakialam, mga ganun. So, there are a lot of factors, but it gives you an idea how much you can earn from a customer
nice.
Dun sa lifetime value niya. Okay, so why is this important, no? Ay, wait lang. Hindi ko pala siya nalagay sa slide, pero kukwento ko na lang. Initially, when I started consulting with this client, tinanong ko sila, parang, okay, how do you acquire now? Sabi nila, may tarp pulling din sa labas. Tapos, meron kaming nag-advertise someone for us before, nag-boost ng ads. So, meron silang data. And then, I asked them, okay, yung ad nila kasi, pag pinakita mo, nung nakita ko yung ad, nakalagay doon, reserve now.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi ko, okay, let's talk about your customer journey, no? Reserve now. Bakit reserve now? Sabi ko, ano bang nangyari kapag nag-inquire sila? Sinabi nila sa akin, Miss Nina, pag nag-inquire sila, ang ginagawa po namin, pinapabisit po namin dito sa dorm. Kasi gusto po namin makita nila. Tsaka mga babae po yung nandito sa dorm, yung mga parents po nila, of course, they want to know how secure the area is, napapapasok ba kami ng guys or ng bisita sa rooms, yung mga ganang stuff. So sabi ko, okay. And then after nilang mag-visit sa site, ano yung nangyayari? Sabi nila, may in-offeran po namin na you reserve today. Tapos merong parang discount pag nag-reserve ka ngayon. Saka merong scarcity na, which is totoo naman yung scarcity nila, na dahil maganda nga yung place, at maganda yung pamamalakad, madami ding nauubusan. So, sabi ko, okay, that's good.
Mm-hmm.
Ito yung sunod na tanong ko. Out of the people na nag-inquire sa inyo sa page from the ads, ilan yung nagbe-visit? Hindi nila alam. Kasi hindi nila tinatrack. So that's number one. So it's like, okay, we have to know. Okay na yun, wag na natin balikan yun kasi that is the past. But now, we have to track. Tapos sabi ko, and out of the 10, let's say, out of the 10 people na nagbe-visit dito, ilan po yung nagpapareserve? Isip na naman sila. Wala po niya, hindi namin alam. So ko, ano, balikan lang natin yung week na to or yung last week. From memory, ilan yung na-serve nyo? Sabi nila, okay, out of 10, merong mga 3.
Mm-hmm.
Na out of 10 na nag-site visit, merong 3 nagpapareserve. So, ibig sabihin, okay, yan yung conversion rate nyo. Out of 10 people na nag-visit, 3 yung nagpapareserve. Okay, number 1 we did in the ad change. Hindi na namin sinabing reserve now. Sabi ko, you are asking too much from people. You showed your dorm in a picture way and in a video way, and you're asking them to reserve. It doesn't make any sense, because the next thing you would want them to do is to visit and schedule a visit to your dorm. Mm-hmm. So we changed the ad. Our call to action is now says, visit, schedule a visit. Mm-hmm. Tapos gumawa lang kami ng Google form para pwede nilang i-schedule yung visit nila doon. Mm-hmm. What else did we do? We also did tracking. As in, tina-track lahat ng pumasok na inquiries, pumapasok siya sa Google Sheet. Mm-hmm. Kasi hindi naman lahat nag-Google form eh.
True. Oh.
Diba? Mm-hmm. So yung lahat ng nag-inquire, tina-track yun, Ginge. Pati lahat ng tumawag sa phone at nag-text, tina-track din sa Google Sheet. And then from there, we know where people are at. And then from there, we know who to follow up. And then we increased our number of visits. Kasi all the staff is saying in the inquiry is, ma'am, schedule po kayo ng visit dito. Kailan po kayo pwedeng pumunta? Mm-hmm. So, mas maganda na rin yung flow nala. So, that is also why important to. Kasi pag sinabi mo parang Facebook ads, metrics lang naman ng Facebook, pag naintindihan ko yung clicks, impressions, okay na. No, you have to tie it up to your business. You have to tie it up also to your goals and objectives, and also yung customer flow nyo o yung journey nyo.
That's
and
true.
It's important na how you can use yung mga metrics na yon in tying it up with your business.
Nice, nice. Yeah. Totoo, no? Kasi parang not a lot of businesses know their customer lifetime value, nor do they see the importance of understanding yung customer journey and how it ties into like running ads, running paid ads.
Let's talk about return on advertising spend. You will always hear this as ROAS. So, ano ba yung ROAS? Ratio of conversion value divided by your ad spend. Parang nila, nosebleed. O sige, ito, expect. Example, no? In more than 2 weeks of running the promo campaign for our HVAC client, last year to, nung wala pang pandemic. we got 473 inquiries from the message inbox, yung sa Facebook page.
Mm-hmm.
Pwera pa dito, Ginge, yung mga tumawag mismo directly doon sa HVAC office, ha? Pati yung mga text. Pero I just want to share this. Ito yung 473 messages or inquiries, more than 50 units sold, at ang value nun is 1.8 million.
Okay.
Okay. Ito siya. Para makita nila, oh, baka ano, sinasabi lang yan ni Nina. Hindi, ito po siya.
Ito ba?
Kasi siyempre kaya may backup, o diba? Ayan, makikita nila pati yung aming mga targeting, no?
Uh-huh.
473 messaging from May 10 to May 31. Yan. So, more than 2 weeks or 3 weeks. Ah, more than 2 weeks, yan. Tapos, ang amount spent natin is 8,989.15. Alright? Mm-hmm. Eh, paano mo nalaman yung sales? Eto, Ginge, if you work with me, talagang pahirapan ko buhay mo. De, joke lang. Katayan ko, I will not work with you kapag hindi mo tinrack yung sales. Kasi hindi natin malalaman. Kasi hindi naman sila automated eh, di ba? Yung mga business owners natin dito sa Pilipinas, actually yung naisip ko kanina, pagkagising ko, Ginge, naisip kagad kita. Sabi ko, sabihin ko kay Ginge, buha kaya siya ng CRM. Mag-develop kaya siya ng CRM na pang Filipino business owners, yung pang small. Kasi ang mamahal, di ba? Tapos hindi naman makarelate. So anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So, talagang sinabi ko sa nila, no, you have to track. So lahat ng pumasok na, ganun ulit, katulad ng sinabi ko sa iyo kanina.
Talagang spreadsheet ito, ah.
O, diba? Time, oo. Pero staff na nila gumawa nito, hindi kami. Pero meron din kami mga staff na pwedeng gumawa nito for the business owners, pero they have to pay. Kasi that's our staff. Mm-hmm. Pero train tong mga staff namin na to, so alam din nila kung paano. But anyway, ayan yung sales nila. May 11 up to 31. Meron pang iba na, actually may iba pang, ang term ko doon, sorry for the word, pero tapon. Ibig sabihin ng tapon is, hindi sila bumili ngayong May, pero dahil nakita nila yung ad nung May, June na sila bumili. So still, diba, kailangan mo pa rin yung i-attribute sa ads. Pero for the sake of this example, yung May sales na lang yung kunin natin.
Yeah.
So 1.8. Sales lang to from the ad gene siya. Alam namin kasi may code kami. Kapag pumasok ka doon sa HVAC office at wala ka nung code, hindi mo makukuha yung price na meron na sa ad mo lang makikita.
Yeah.
That's how tricky it can get. Kasi you have to find a way on how to track it specifically. So I told the client, meron akong client na car tint. Sabi ko sa kanya, you have to give me like a pricing na from ads lang natin. Na alam mo kapag yung customer nag-walk-in dito at tinanong yung price na yon, from ads yun galing.
Okay.
Kasi, so iba yung pricing namin sa ads, iba yung offer namin sa ads, bukod dun sa iba nilang offer. Kasi they also have other sources of, yung sources ng traffic nila eh. Yung Facebook group, etc. Okay, so let's now compute for the ROAS, no? Or the return on advertising spend. Again, ang sabi niya, ratio down ng conversion value divided by your ad spend. So, ang value natin is 1.8 million. Divided by yung cost natin na amount spent, which is around 9,000. Mm-hmm. Ang lumabas is 201.24. What does it mean? It means in every peso that we are spending on advertising, we get 201 back.
Oh.
Yeah. Which is super, super cool and malaki.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi
200.
Diba? Yung iba nga parang, sa iba parang, actually, sabi nga ng mga iba, pag nag-start ka, if you spend 1 peso, you get 1 peso back, okay na yun. Pero syempre, marami pa rin factors dito kasi yung cost of goods sold ng aircon.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi na naka-factor in dito. But this will give you an idea na how much you're spending and how much is returning. And also, again, consider other factors. Is it profitable for you or not? Kasi we're not saying na Facebook is always the answer. Hindi po yun, totoo. And also, advertising on Facebook is not magic. Mm-hmm. And your advertisers are also not magician, di ba?
Yeah.
Like ako, I'm not a magician. There are campaigns na talaga namang hindi nagpa-fly, and may mga campaigns na nagpa-fly. Pero we always wanna control what we can and manage what we can. Kasi if you do your research, your customer research, if you do have your offer na ganito, hindi siya nag-click, o baka ibang offer yung mag-click sa market, it's just always there, yung mga factors na gano'n. Pero this is how you compute for your ROAS.
So, ulitin natin, Nina, no? Yung 1.8 million dito, yan yung kita nila, right? And then yung 8,000 dito, around 9,000, yan yung ad spending nila. And then, yan yung ROAS mo, yung 201.24. So, itong ROAS, no, baka naman iniisip ng mga tao, baka itong computation na to, para lang to sa Facebook. Hindi naman, no. It's, you can use yung return on ad spending wherever, whenever you spend for advertising, no. So, basically, kahit na Google yan, you spend for Google, yung 9,000 na yan, it can be like, spinend ko siya sa Facebook, spinning ko siya sa Google. It just so happened yung example natin today is really yung actual spending nung pseudo, yung demo customer natin ngayon.
Tama. Plus, tama yung change. Also, even with traditional marketing, let's say you spend 5,000 pesos on flyering.
Yeah.
Or you spend 1,000 pesos on that tarp.
Mm-hmm.
How many customers did you get out of it?
Mm-hmm.
Or meron ka ba talagang gusto makuha customers o gusto mo lang branding? Na para mas ma-known ka lang nila. So, meron, again, different objectives. And you are very right no, when you said na hindi lang to for advertising. It can be applied to any form of advertising kahit man digital or not.
Yeah.
So, you can conclude na what are you gaining or what are you, anong return nun sa spend mo. Okay. Kanina nag-usap tayo tungkol sa measure, analyze, improve, and control, no? Actually, na-touch ko na siya eh. Doon sa basic na mga metrics kanina. Pero just to also give an example about this, you can ask yourself, parang, are you profitable? Diba? So,
yes.
ROAS. Check your ROAS. Check your lifetime customer value. Let's say, you acquired a customer for 5,000 pesos.
Mm-hmm.
Eh, ang lifetime customer value pala niya, kalahating million. Diba?
Yeah.
So, kapag tinignan mo siya in a nutshell, 5,000 pesos ang mahal niyan. Stop mo na yung ads na yan. Pero wait.
Mm-hmm.
You acquired this for 5,000 pero bibigyan ka ng kalahating million long term. Provided that okay yung service mo and maraming factors, diba? So,
yeah.
Ayan nga. Yun sa lifetime customer value, no? Ito yung cost per acquisition namin. A client is paying 20 pesos per inquiry. Based on my conversation with client, out of 10 inquiries, 3 yung nagbe-visit sa dorm, 2 yung nagpapareserve.
Mm-hmm.
And become tenants. So from here, kung 20 yung nag-inquire, tapos at 10 yung nag-inquire, that's 200 pesos na, no, na spend.
Yes.
Na yung nag-visit. Ay, pero out of that 10, 2 lang yung magpapareserve. So kapag dinivide mo yon, ang cost per acquisition mo is 200 pesos divided by 2. 100 pesos. Tama?
Yes.
Per cost, per tenant. Ang laki ng return nun dito pa lang sa, actually yung 6,000 per month pa lang, okay na eh, di ba?
Yes.
Pero yung lifetime customer value, 180,000 and you only acquire the customer for 100 pesos.
Yeah.
Di ba? O di sample, 100 pesos, lagay ka tarp dyan sa labas or magpa-flyering ka. 100 pesos, yung flyering na yun, 2 hours mo lang ibabayad. Yun, actually, cost pa lang yun nung ano,
flyer.
Mo.
Nung no, papel.
Oo. Pero siyempre, hindi ko sinasabi mo kayo mag-flyering. No. Kailangan, ano, lahat ng pwedeng sources doon ka, where your customer at, diba?
Hmm.
Hindi ko naman sabi yung Facebook advertising lang. No. There, lahat ng pwede mong sources ng traffic or ng acquisition mo ng customer, gawin mo. Pero we have to do it smart in a smart way.
Mm-hmm.
Yun. Yung cash flow. Ayan. So, baka optimization question to. What type of audiences are giving more back to you? For example, eto, isa to sa mga example na, etong nasa kaliwa, yung may car, ang target namin dito, male.
Mm-hmm.
Etong sa kanan, ang target namin dito, BPO.
Ah, BPO.
Kasi ayan, yes. Tingnan mo sa copy, you work 40 hours and brave the heavy traffic. Based on the customer avatar that we created for the client, we saw na yung mga BPO people kasi this is a finance app eh.
Mm-hmm.
Know the person dito, Jean. Sasabihin ko sa'yo mamaya. Partner mo din siya. But anyway, mm-hmm. Parang na-identify namin na yung mga BPO employees, they get more money compared to other employees, di ba?
Yes.
They are being paid more. Reality yon. I mean, ngayon siguro hindi na masyado, pero nung time ko, like 10 years, 15 years ago, we are really being paid more. Sa pag kahit entry-level ka lang, entry-level mo, 15K, 12, versus yung iba na 12K, 8K.
Mm-hmm.
So, ang realize namin is, yun, meron silang mga dapat na extra money, pero hindi. Ayan, you get paid more than your friends, but you still find it hard to save. What if there is a free tool, ganyan-ganyan. So, ayan yung copy. Eto siya, pag tinignan mo dun sa ads. Manager. Tingnan mo yung BPO target namin. 6. Eto, male top gear. We're paying 6,044. RP to eh. Indonesian rupees. Rupees to eh.
Okay.
Tapos yung female is 6,000. Yan. Pero yung BPO, tingnan mo 6,200, diba? Again, this is in rupees, no? But if you can see yung sa single male, 20 to 35 single, it's 59,000.
Mm-hmm.
So, what does it tell you? Kaya siya naka-off eh. Hindi namin siya nire-run. Alam mo yun?
Mm-hmm.
Tapos, yung Cosmopolitan Mag plus parents, medyo mataas din, 30. Okay pa din siya, to be honest. Kasi etong mga 30, 50 na yun, nasa mga 50 pesos to 70 pesos to per app install. Okay pa rin siya. Pero but if you look at this, nang i-compare mo siya sa ibang audience, you can reallocate the budget doon sa mga audience na mas mura. Diba? Tsaka yeah. Baka kasi mas relevant yun app sa kanila.
Yeah,
mga
yeah. That's true. Yeah.
Okay. Next. What type of creative works well with your objective? Diba? So, this one, ito yung mga different creatives na sinukukan, na ginamit namin din sa HVAC client, yung mm-hmm. sa mayroong 1.8 million na sales. So, based on this, makikita mo sa ads manager, saan mas marami yung nag-inquire, saan mas marami nagme-message, or if you can also tie it up dun sa sales mo, ganon. Iba-iba yan ng copy. Yung isa, get a free desk fan. Yung isa naman, save on your electricity. Yung isa naman, free installation. Kasi split type eh. Magkano ang split type installation? Diba, Jane? 7K and
up. Oo, mahal.
Diba? Yun. So, yun. Ask yourself what type of creative works well with your objective. And then, From there, you can again look at the frequency, look at the cost per result, or cost per inquiry nyo, cost per lead nyo, and then decide from there.
Nice.
Tapos, is it time to change or update the creative? Katulad ng sinabi ko sa'yo kanina, yung sa frequency, 2.5, ad fatigue. Okay, so you cannot manage what you do not measure. It's hard really also for small business owners na talagang itrack yung mga inquiries, yung mga sales, yung kanilang business. But really, this is one of the things na kailangan na itrack mo yung, sabi ni Neil na panood ko during one of your videos na yung parting advice niya or words niya is parang grow your list, diba? Sure. Or mag, ano mo, yung list mo, itatrack mo, idodocument mo. Siyempre, when you grow your list, pwede bang wala kang listahan? You have to manage it. And you have to measure. Kasi you cannot also improve something na you don't measure.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. Yun. What else? So, what other features or strategies you can start executing? Diba? Mm-hmm. Do you want to get more messages? You look at your offer and see other angles you can use? There. Ito naman, sample lang to dun sa what other strategies or features na meron din sa Facebook. You can also do Messenger and bot. You can tie it up and then go back to the video of Neil. And ano, ito sample to nung isang bot na sa Messenger ads na ginawa namin na may kasamang bot for a real estate.
Yeah.
Shout out to one of our members na gumawa ng bot. So, ayan, we have here the creative video and then the creative image on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
This is one of the examples. January 19, as you can see, Ginge Real Estate to, ang dami, more than 20. So, I'm not sure, in a day, if you get more than 20, in a month, that's 600 inquiries. If you cannot convert one person from that, there is something wrong with your sales presentation, or I don't know, diba? Kasi this is very targeted to OFWs, eh. And also to people who are... Wait lang. Sophia, wait. Sophia. Minimize the volume, anak. Ayan. So, yun. Ano na, saan ako?
Yung parents.
So, OFWs. And then also, very targeted to doon sa income na who can buy yung kung ano yung sinesell. So, also, if wala rin ako convert, let's say, you have to coordinate with your advertiser or kung ikaw yung nag-advertise, you have to check. Ano ba yung mga ano bang type of people yung na-attract ng ad? Baka hindi sila. So, palitan mo yung audience. Yeah. Diba? Yun. So, ito yung lang yung example ng in terms of analysis and measuring and also improving sa ating DMAIC. you have to check then from time to time from the things that you have na na-analyze mo dun sa metrics, ano yung pwede mong i-improve, ano yung pwede mong i-control later on.
Nice.
Yun. That's it. Yay!
Thank you so much, Nin. So, ang dami kong natutunan din, no, from you. And I hope, sige, there. I hope marami rin natutunan yung mga viewers natin today. So, if you have, like, questions, no, about, like, the different metrics of Facebook ads, you can just comment on the section below and we'll get to that. No? We will answer all of your inquiries. So thank you so much, Nins. I won't take up too much of your time anymore, but I know ang dami naming natutunan from you and basing ko, alam mo yun, ang dami eh. Like, yung kunwari ako, natutunan ko today yung ad fatigue, kung ano yung titignan ko rin, and check ko yung difference ng click links versus the clicks. Tapos, it's really also refresher, no, na parang you really have to go back to your customer journey and tie it in also to your ad, to how you do your ads as well. No? So, thank you so much. So, if they have questions, Nins, where can they get in touch with you?
Ayun, I flashed earlier yung aking Instagram and Facebook. They can just go to follow me on Instagram, nins.mendoza, and then also in Facebook, fb.com/ninsmendoza, para they would know yung mga updates.
Yes.
Yun. That's okay. It. Jish, thank you also for having me here. It's an honor. Yay!
Thank you. Okay, so lahat ng mga viewers, so all of you who are watching, if you like this video, kindly like, share, subscribe, and if you are on YouTube, kindly click on the notification bell as well. Alright, that's another episode of GTV Business Over Coffee. Thank you for watching.
Bye!
Bye!